Welcome back. You're watching Road to Success, the key to your next level in business. This week, we're honored to meet John Theuri, a lecturer at Riara University and also a social entrepreneur. Karibu sana to our show.
Thank you so much, Catherine.
I know as a lecturer, you must have wider knowledge than most of us. And of course, you're also a social entrepreneur. When you say you're a social entrepreneur, what does that mean? Just for our audience to be clear.
Thank you so much for having me, Catherine. A social entrepreneur is somebody who looks at societal problems from a different perspective, so that now you are keen to solve the challenges that are in society and you create a social impact.
And as a lecturer, what is your department?
My department is the School of Business. So my areas, I handle entrepreneurship, management, and marketing, those diverse areas. I've been doing that for the last 17 years.
John, then you would be the right person to answer a lot of these questions from our audience. We do this every other month. The first question is, one of our viewers wants to know whether culture is an important part of carrying business. Interesting.
Thank you, Catherine. It's a very interesting question, and it has many facets. But to just bring it closer home, there is a famous saying that says, when you go to Rome, you do as the Romans do. There is a concept we call SWOT analysis. Culture falls in there because the sociocultural aspects of any community are very key. For example, if you want to sell fish, you must ask yourself, do those people who stay in that environment eat fish as a delicacy? If they don't, it's a cultural element. So when you introduce fish, it will take you longer to convince them to try eating fish. Maybe they don't look at fish as something edible. So your business will have a higher chance of failure if you miss out the concept of culture.
Okay, this one is from Cordiera. It's from Bill Clinton Mabumba. He's asking, he says, I kept rabbit at home in large numbers, but it didn't help since I had no good market. How can you help? That's part one. Two, I also had a plan of transporting sardines, dagger and omena to Nairobi, but I'm only having one customer who doesn't need it much. Is this idea beneficial? So part one,
yes.
We'll start with part one about the rabbits.
Rabbit farming is growing in Kenya, in the region. Why? Because rabbits provide a very good source of meat that, to some extent, they say is cholesterol free. And therefore, rabbit farming has grown leaps and bounds. We have organizations that help rabbit farmers. There is one that is in Nairobi. So possibly we can even give the young man contacts of that. But the second thing is that for every business, you must find your market. If you begin it the other way around, it gives you a challenge. Because then you have the rabbits, you don't have the market.
Yeah.
The other thing is refrigeration. Sometimes you can slaughter and refrigerate so that when you find a market, you are able to deliver. But there are places where within Nairobi where they buy lots of rabbit meat. Possibly the young man might need to come down here to Nairobi and look for rabbit farmers. The second thing also is to look at the dietary habits of that environment. Are people willing to begin trying rabbit meat? Are there places where people eat possibly fish and other types of meat where they are willing to explore with rabbit meat? That can be a beginning because you can create a market for your rabbit meat. But usually in business, you first look for the market, and then you begin producing. If you produce and then you look for the market, sometimes you can have a big challenge.
Okay, and then he's also planning to transport like the sardines, the dagger and the omena to Nairobi. And he only has one customer who doesn't need it much.
That's a good beginning.
Is this idea beneficial?
I think the idea is beneficial. Possibly the way to look at it again, the good thing with that is that he'll be buying from the local market or something like that, is to ask the current customer to recommend at least 3 or 4 other people who usually buy these kind of things. Again, also, he may have to come down, come and see that customer and look for places where these particular items are bought. One place like that is Gikomba Market, huge market for this kind of product. So I think it's a viable idea. It's an excellent idea. And he should pursue it further. and now begin to have forums with those who buy so that he can increase the number of people who are buying. Also, talk to the current customer. Why is that customer not willing to buy more stocks? Is it the credit facilities? What is it? Is it the market? Explore ways of partnering with that person so that they can increase possibly the amount of these sardines and omena they buy.
John, the next one is from Edwin from Kericho. He's asking, he has started his business, he's done his business 3 times and all have failed. And this is between February and May this year. He has used all his money, over 40,000K, and now he has nothing. He wants to know what has gone wrong.
It's a very good question from Edwin from Kericho. Maybe the best way of looking at it is there are lessons from failure, because failure is a stepping stone to success. So he's asking a very critical question for most of the people who are starting businesses, budding entrepreneurs, potential entrepreneurs, and new entrepreneurs.
Because they say 80% of businesses that are started in the first year fail.
Yes, yes, yeah. They give those kind of statistics. Sometimes they are neither here nor there, because there are many reasons of failure. Maybe we can begin with, if we had an idea of what kind of business, that would have really helped us, because there are certain businesses, depending on where you are doing them, they have a higher rate of success or failure. So possibly we could ask Edwin to give us more information on the kind of business, the target market, and so on and so forth. But having said that, there are many reasons why businesses fail. It could be because you have underestimated the needs of the customers. It could be because of your customer service. It could be because of location. There are a million and one reasons why a business will fail. So for this particular case, we can only speculate, because we don't have the critical information that we need from Edwin.
Vera from Bugoma is asking, where do I get business ideas?
Interesting, Vera. Thank you for that question, Vera. Bungoma is a big county with lots of business ideas. Now, sometimes you need to go to the marketplace. There's a huge market in Bungoma. Go into that marketplace and you make sure you go early. For example, you can be there by 8 o'clock. Spend your time observing the activities in the market, the trucks bringing in produce, the trucks taking out produce, the amount of fruits, the amount of food, the amount of the number of people who come in there, and then talk to one or two people there. Find out the kind of business they are doing. That will be a rich source of business idea. Sometimes you get ideas by observing the way people carry out their business. So that would be my first advice. Go into your local market and look around. See how many people are coming to buy fruits. See how many people are eating fruits in that particular environment, or the kind of food stuffs that move in that market. That can be a very rich, because some people say you can never go wrong with food.
Final question is from Cynthia, who's watching from Kahawa. She completed her high school in 2014, and due to lack of school fees, she's back home. So she's asking, please help her with what she can do to make her life successful.
It's a very sad scenario where you find our young people at home, they are sitting at home, they are sitting on their gifts and talents. How will your gifts present you before kings and queens when you are seated? Because gifts make room for people. What I would advise Cynthia is to get out of that environment where she's in and go out there to the marketplace. Look for organizations that are willing to take in volunteers and volunteer her services. There are several. You can volunteer in, for example, places like St. John's Ambulance. You can volunteer at the Red Cross. There are many avenues that are possible. And you see now what you'll be doing. One, you'll be opening up for other networks. You'll meet many other young people. As you engage, that's where you get to hear of what other people are doing. You get new ideas, you get impetus, and also you are encouraged. Where your hope was down, it's lifted up. But as long as you are staying at home, sometimes you almost look like the world has come to an end, yet opportunities are out there, but they will not find you at home. You must find them out there. So we are encouraging Cynthia, get out of the home. So ideas are several. We are encouraging our young people, come out of your comfort zone. Come out of the home environment. Even walking out there Sometimes even walking is better than being in a matatu, because you get to see several things. You get to interact with people out there. You see what other people are doing. There are some brilliant ideas out there, and you can upscale some of those ideas. But don't sit on your talents.
Thank you, John, for really taking the time to come and answer a lot of these questions. From young people, old people, it doesn't matter where they are. We thank you for your time.
Thank you so much, Catherine, for having me. I want to see how we can help our young people. So thank you for opening up this forum. Thank you for the work you are doing for our young people.
Thank you for watching Road to Success, the key to your next level in business. We do encourage you to continue writing to us, sharing your comments. And if you have any queries, we do have the experts who come every week and are ready to answer your questions. Do have a blessed week. Road to Success is brought to you by Equity Bank.
Equity Bank, you are listening, caring partner.